About Islam, and you haven't read the Quran before, right?
No, I didn't.
Okay, sure. So, what's the question? By the way, we have a chapter about her.
Really?
Yeah. Look.
Really?
Hai guys, jumpa lagi di Bang Jaka Channel. Kali ini seru banget, guys, karena kita kali ini bakal mendengar gimana wawancara seorang mualaf bernama Muhammad Ali Dawah di Inggris, guys, ya. Nah, kali ini, guys, Muhammad Ali Dawah ketika dia berdakwah, dia kedatangan seorang cewek yang cantik banget, guys, yang bertanya sama dia, guys. Jadi, guys, di kota London ada yang namanya sebuah lapangan namanya Hyde Park, guys. Jadi, di hari Minggu, orang-orang, guys, boleh berdakwah di sini, guys, ya, termasuk muslim, guys. Jadi, guys, Ali Dawah ini, guys, selalu datang kemari, guys, setiap hari Minggu, guys, dan dia sangat bersemangat untuk berdakwah, guys, ya. Biasanya, guys, ya, Ali datang kemari mulai jam 1 siang sampai jam 8 malam, guys. Jadi penasaran kan? Yuk langsung aja kita tonton bareng-bareng, guys.
But yeah, so Sister Madeline, how you doing?
I'm fine, thanks.
That's good. You had a question. You said that your friend had a question about Islam, and you haven't read the Quran before, right?
No, I didn't.
Okay, sure. So what's the question?
I'm asking, what do you do to people that don't believe in your God?
Okay, are you ready to hear this?
Yeah.
It's going to be very brutal.
I'm fine.
We give them dawah. We invite them to Islam.
Okay.
So I don't know what your friend told you, but people that don't believe, for example, in Islam, they're in categories. So there's the people of the book, Ahlul Kitab. So there's, we as Muslims, we believe the Jews and the Christians are people of the book. Are you a Christian?
Yeah, I am.
Okay, good. So we will class you as the people of the book. So you are closer to us than the polytheists. Mm-hmm. So the polytheists go down the categories of idol worshippers. So these are people who worship statues. You don't agree with that, I don't agree with that, right? Okay, good. So as Christians, that's the reason why Allah says in the Quran, tell the people of the book, which is you, we come together and we worship God alone, which you say the Father.
Yeah.
Yes. So in a nutshell, we are commanded in Islam that we live in harmony and peace together with the Christians and the Jews. So when Islam was ruling the world, a vast majority of the world, a lot of Christians lived under the rule of Islam in peace. They had their own cathedrals, their own churches, their own laws. They could drink alcohol, eat pork in their vicinity. So, and they were a protected group, meaning, for example, the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, even Umar ibn Khattab, he was one of the second caliph of Islam, when he took over Jerusalem, he had a covenant, a treaty with the Christians and the Jews, that they will live side by side in peace, and they have rights. If an external enemy was to come and attack the Christians, the Muslims will be there to defend them. If an external enemy came to attack the Jews, the Muslims will be there to defend them. And the same goes if an external enemy came to attack the Muslims, the Jews and the Christians will help the Muslims to fight them. So there is a perception that in Islam it says, you know, the disbeliever, you kill them. This is nonsense. This is only talking about specific individuals who are hostile. So in the Quran, in chapter 60, verse 8, Allah says in the Quran, we do not forbid you from being just and kind to those who do not fight you and kick you out from your houses. So in a nutshell, to answer your question, Sister Madeline, we are told that a principle is, number one, we share Islam with everybody. Christian, Jew, Hindu, whoever you are. That's the number one thing that we believe, that the disbelievers have a right, because they want to hear the message of Islam. That's number one. Number two, if they choose to reject it, then that's upon them, because in the Quran, in Surah Baqarah, it's the second chapter of the Quran, there is no compulsion in religion. I can't force you to accept Islam. It defeats the purpose. If I'm forced you, then you didn't really embrace it. So in Islam, strictly, nobody, no Muslim is allowed to force a non-Muslim to accept Islam.
Okay.
If that makes sense.
Yeah, sure. Thank you.
No problem. Do you have any other questions? Do you have anything else?
No, that's okay. It.
So let me talk just quickly.
Yeah.
I know you need to go. About what our belief is in pertaining to our doctrine. We believe there is one God.
Mm-hmm.
We believe he's not a man. He's not a statue. He's not an idol. There is nothing like him. So are you a Christian that believes Jesus to be God? Or do you believe Jesus to be God?
No, I think he's just a creature of him. He's his son, or he is not God, but...
Are you a Jehovah's Witness?
No.
Dia pun gak percaya, guys, kalau Yesus itu Tuhan. Dia menganggap bahwasanya Yesus itu ya manusia biasa juga, guys, ya.
No,
okay,
I'm
what denomination?
Catholic.
You're Catholic. Okay, so good. So you believe that, for example, the mother of Mary, by the way, we have a chapter about her.
Really?
Yeah, look.
Really?
Pas disebut Bunda Maria, kaget ya, guys. Mau tahu kenapa, guys? Karena di Bible kan cuman 61 kali, guys, disebut Maria di situ, guys, ya. Tapi di Al-Quran malah Maria ini diberikan sebuah satu nama surat, guys. Nama suratnya adalah surat Maryam. Berarti Maria di Al-Quran itu lebih diistimewakan, guys. Makanya cewek cantik ini terkejut banget, guys. Loh, kok bisa ada ya Maria di Al-Quran? Makanya.
This is very interesting, bro. Can I have a... So, look, check this out, sister, ya. So, I'll open the Quran on my app.
Oh.
Yeah, look. I'm gonna write there, Maryam. Look, chapter Mary. We've got a whole chapter on the name of the mother of Jesus. And Jesus is talked about in the Quran as well. We as Muslims, we have to believe in Jesus. Any Muslim that says he doesn't believe in Jesus, he can't be a Muslim. So we believe, and also the Quran came also to defend her honor. Because the Jews said about her, Barakallahu fik, the Jews used to say, not always, obviously, the Jews back in those times when Jesus came, and we believe in his miraculous birth, we believe in his miracles that he done, we believe he spoke in the cradle when he was a baby, he spoke to defend his mother, because the Jews used to say that they used to claim Mary to be an adulterer, I would have been that. Like, and we, the Quran comes to defend that, that this is not true. We believe she was one of the most amazing women to walk this earth. There are four that the Prophet Muhammad mentioned, she's one of them. She was an amazing woman. So we have utmost respect for the mother of Jesus, we have utmost respect for Jesus, and all we say is the following, we should not worship anybody except God. This is the main message of Islam. All the Muslims here, we worship God alone. We do not worship any idols, and that's why we tell the Christians that Jesus, because some believe Jesus is God. We say no. How could a man be God, which you agree to?
Yeah.
And we call this the fitrah. You know what you said when I said this to you? We say you are programmed to know this.
Mm-hmm.
Even if I didn't tell you about Islam, if I said to you, do you believe Jesus is God? You say no, right?
Yeah.
So the main message of Islam is what? Let's worship the one true God. And Jesus is his prophet,
mm-hmm.
yes? Like in the Bible, it says in Acts 2, verse 22, Jesus of Nazareth, a man chosen by God, with wonders, miracles, and signs which God did by him, and you are a witness to it. So Islam, in a nutshell, sister, is worship God alone, except you have the Old Testament, you have the New Testament, this is the final testament. This approves and talks about the other scriptures.
Mm-hmm.
It affirms Moses, it affirms Jesus, it affirms Abraham. All it says is, this is the final testament,
mm-hmm.
accept this, and believe in it.
Okay.
Nah, gimana guys? Mantap banget kan dialognya? Jadi menurut yang saya tangkap, bahwasanya cewek ini mendapat titipan pertanyaan dari temannya guys ya, tentang bagaimana pendapat Muhammad Ali Dawah ini tentang orang-orang yang nggak percaya dengan tuannya orang Islam guys. Nah, jawaban Pak Muhammad Ali Dawah ini guys jelas banget guys, bahwasanya nggak ada paksaan untuk memeluk agama Islam guys. Walaupun berdakwah itu sunnah hukumnya, tapi Islam itu nggak memaksakan untuk agama lain untuk masuk ke agama Islam guys. Dan Muhammad Ali Dawah ini juga menjelaskan dan menegaskan bahwasanya di dalam Islam itu benar-benar nggak ada pemaksaan di dalam beragama guys. Harus melalui kesadaran dari dalam diri guys ya. Kalau kita perhatikan guys ya, dari mimik wajah cewek ini ya kan, cewek cantik ini guys sangat bersemangat guys ya mendengarkan penjelasan Muhammad Ali Dawah. Jadi aura kecantikannya itu keluar semua guys ya. Nah, kalau kita perhatikan ini nampak jelas bahwasanya cewek ini udah mulai dikit-dikit menerima kebenaran Islam guys. Tapi dia masih ada beberapa hal yang mungkin harus mendapat jawaban guys ya dari pertanyaan-pertanyaannya. Tapi kalau menurut saya guys, mudah-mudahan aja cewek ini dalam waktu dekat dia bakal menjadi mualaf juga guys, karena bisa kita lihat dari mimik wajahnya guys, dia sangat antusias mendengarkannya guys ya. Dan yang di luar dugaan guys, cewek ini kaget ketika disebut Bunda Maria guys. Ternyata di dalam Al-Quran juga disebut Bunda Maria, bahkan nama Maria itu guys diberikan dalam satu surat di Al-Quran guys. Ini guys benar-benar luar biasa menurut cewek ini guys ya. Memang guys ya, di Al-Quran itu ada surat yang bernama surat Maryam guys. Memang Maria itu diistimewakan di dalam Al-Quran guys, bahkan ada juga surat Al-Imran guys, yaitu keluarga Imran, itu juga keluarga dari Maria guys ya. Nah, bagaimana menurut pendapat kamu guys? Silahkan berikan tanggapan, sanggahan, opini dan kritik di kolom komentar. Semoga bermanfaat dan menjadi ilmu baru bagi kita semua guys ya. Oke, saya cukupkan video yang sampai sini. Sampai jumpa lagi di video selanjutnya. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Ciao.